This is a brief video to show you how to fade in and fade out movies. Use the transparency and the pen tool and to create a end title. All right, so you're gonna have to find two clips that were shot at different locations for this movie. This movie is only going to be 12 seconds long plus an end title. So first I'm gonna open up my Premiere project. Takes me a couple minutes. Once this is up, I'll open a new project. And I'm going to call it Exercise 2. I'm going to make sure that it is set into the right place. For me, it's going to be set in my Video 1 folder and Assignment 1. And I'm going to choose, I'm going to make a new folder called Exercise 2. Create. Now you might have these assets in some other location and that's fine. It's going to open. I'm going to set my graphics window so the workspace looks like yours. Here we go. Now I'm going to double click here and import some media. I'm going to import two clips. And if I hold down the command key, I can import them both at the same time. All right. I'm going to take this first clip and I'm going to make the sequence out of this first clip. So I hit Control Click. I scroll down to New Sequence from Clip. I'm going to make that go away. Now the sequence is set. I'm going to go back to the new clip. I'm going to load it up into the source window and just pull down the video. Now I'm going to go to the second clip. I'm going to bring it up. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to drag the video only. Notice it's a much bigger clip. Now, the way I'm going to choose to do this is I want the clip to show first is the clip with the trees in it, not the sky shot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this first clip and I'm going to just click and drag it so it goes over to the top. I'm going to bring this one down to the middle just to make it more even. So I've just situated them now so that they're in a different location. All right. So like I said before, this whole clip is going to be only, this whole movie is going to be 12 seconds. So I can try to find out where 12 seconds is and just kind of look at the counter over here. Or I can actually go to the counter itself and just hit 12:00 for 12 seconds and 0 frames. I hit return, it goes right to 12, which is fantastic. Now I'm going to introduce a new tool, and that is the razor blade. I could actually take my regular selection tool and drag it in, but instead I'm going to use the razor blade. And right where my playhead is located, I'm going to click, and that cuts the clip. I'm going to click again. And I'm going to cut the clip there too. So now they're exactly the same length. I'm going to use the selection tool, click on the stuff I don't want, hit delete, and now I know it's exactly the right size. There you go. Now I'm going to zoom in a little bit. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so you can see it. And my goal is to fade in and then fade out a little bit and the top clip so you can kind of see the under clip showing a little bit, and then fade everything out at the end. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to go to the beginning. And the way I'm going to fade in is I'm going to travel right between the on this side where the clips begin, and I'm going to drag them out. And notice when I drag them out, I have these lines there. Those are lines that will deal with opacity. If you don't see those, you click this clip. And you go down to here and show keyframes, go to opacity, and click on show opacity. I have mine already, and so I don't have to do that. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fade in. And since I'm going to have this top video just fading in, I can just scooch this bottom one over a little bit so I don't have to fade in both. So I'm just going to take, and you know how to do this already, I'm going to take the selection tool, just bring it in a little bit. So now I only have to deal with this clip. So when I fade it in, the way I do it is I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can see a little bit better, is I'm going to take my pen tool. The pen tool is also used for you fading out the sound of the clip in our last exercise. I'm going to make one dot. I'm going to move my playhead just so I know exactly where it is. I'm going to put one point right here, and I'm going to put one point at the beginning. And what that's going to do is that's going to fade in the clip. I'll show you. There. Now, notice there's two clips there, but the clip on the top, as long as it's perfectly opaque, is not going to show the clip below. It's always the clip on the top that gets played. At some point, somewhere down the line, I'm going to decide I want to start fading in the second clip. And what I'm actually doing is making the top clip slightly transparent. So I'm going to take my pen tool and I'm going to put a keyframe there. Then I'm going to move it a little bit, and then I'm going to put another keyframe, and I'm going to click drag it, not all the way down, but just so that it's halfway down. And so watch what happens at that point. So when I play the movie at this point, you'll see it fades in. You see the woods, then you see this fading in of this other clip, which kind of gives it an eerie feeling. I'm going to back it up, and like I said before, I'm going to fade out both of them. And so I'm actually going to take the pen tool, I'm going to do a clip, a keyframe there, I'm going to go to the end, I'm going to make another keyframe, bring it down. I'm going to do the same thing over here. Actually, what I can do, because I'm going to fade both of them out simultaneously, I'm going to move the playhead so it's completely overhead. I'm going to put another keyframe here and a last keyframe here. And so after the movie plays for a bit, you see both of them simultaneously and they fade out. And that's the end of the movie. Now I'm going to show you how to make a title. These go at the beginning and the end of your project one. To make a title, you go to the toolbar and go to the T for type tool. You click on that, and now you actually go to the program monitor and click. It's taking me a second. All right. Once I clipped it, I can then type something. I'm going to just type the end. And if it's not the size I want, there's a whole lot of controls with this, but right now I'm going to just click the end and I'm going to drag this out. All right, so that is the end. I'll talk to you more about the end titles in depth later on. So the last thing in this movie is I'm going to fade in and out the title. So I'm going to go back to my pen tool. And notice this also has a transparency line. I'm going to hit one keyframe there, and I'm going to go to the front, make a keyframe so it fades in. When it's low, that means it's fully transparent or invisible. When it is fully to the top, that means it's fully opaque or fully visible. So I'm going to move it over. I'm going to hold on to my keyframe here, and then I'm going to go to the end and bring it down. So the middle keyframes are just to hold the place where it is fully opaque and fully visible. So this is what the movie looks like now. All right, goes through, the doll fades out, the end. It's a kind of long the end, but we'll live with that. Okay, so that's your movie. The only thing you have to do now is you have to export the movie itself. So, and you know that from the previous exercise. So, hope this was helpful.